17th to order. May we all please stand and place it to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Will everyone please remain standing? We're going to ask Pastor Sanford to please come and give us a prayer.
Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, again for this day and this hour. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for this city of Inkster, Lord Jesus. We thank you for the mayor, Lord Jesus, all the official staff, Lord Jesus. We pray you continue to bless the city. They go forward in your word, Lord Jesus. We pray, Lord Jesus, you bless and continue to shower them with your love and mercy in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Next step, roll call.
Mayor Nolan.
Present.
Councilwoman Whiteley.
Present.
Councilman Oden.
Present.
Councilwoman Mitchell.
Present.
Councilwoman Howard.
Here.
Mayor Pro Tem Williams.
Present.
And Councilman Chisholm.
Here.
We have 7 present today, and we do have a quorum.
Okay. Approval for the agenda.
Hold on, you
got to add those items. Hold on, you got to add them.
You have to add
report.
C and D. You gotta ask C and D. The vote, the 2 votes that was taken in closing.
Okay. Okay. There's been some things added on and taken away from the agenda. We took one thing from the public hearing and from the second reading. And
that was the first reading.
First reading.
And we're taking that off, right?
And
right.
Then you're adding items C and D for closed session.
And we adding item C and D per closed session. C and first one?
Dukes. And Smith was the...
And Smith was D. So, someone approved it already?
No, you need a vote.
Oh. A motion to approve the agenda? Support?
Support.
All in favor say aye.
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 All opposed say nay. The yeas have it. Okay. Presentations and discussions. We have a presentation from the Michigan Municipal League. Ms. Lewis Allen Richardson, could you please come up, please?
Good evening, Council.
And Mayor Susan Rowe.
And those that are sitting also at the table. I'm Lois Allen Richardson, and I'm City Council member for the City of Ypsilanti. And I am past board member of the League of Michigan Municipal League Board of Trustees. I'm also president of the Michigan Black Caucus of Locally Elected Officials and president of the Elected Officials Academy. I'm here tonight with wearing the hat representing the Elected Officials Academy, or EOA as we call it. And here with me I have Susan Rowe and also Kelly Warren, who is the program administrator for the EOA. And I would like now to ask Mayor Pro Tem Williams if you would come forward, please.
It's all good.
He's coming back, right?
With Susan here with me, we would like to present you with this plaque and pin for graduating level 1 of the Local Officials Academy. And while she's pinning you, I will read the plaque. Elected Officials Academy, the Michigan Municipal League hereby certifies that Tim Williams has successfully completed all the requirements as set forth by the Elected Officials Academy Advisory Board for the Level 1 Education Award of the Elected Officials Academy, and it's signed Daniel P. Gilmartin, Executive Director and CEO, March 2017. Congratulations, Mayor Pro Tem. We got the photos. And I want to speak to the council members, if I may. I'd like to say to each and every one of you, and invite you to participate in the Elected Officials Academy. We now have four levels, and this is just the beginning, level one. And we have included information about it. Each one of you received a packet.
Thank you.
Blue packet. And just to tell you a little bit, I've been on council now for 16 and a half years. And had the pleasure of working with your beautiful clerk there in the past. But when I was first elected in the year 2000, I could not wait. Once they told me, I didn't know anything about the EOA, but once they told me about it, I couldn't wait to go to the first weekend, the the basic weekend, and I went to that, and I've been taking classes ever since. And even though I'm about to finish, I have completed, and so has Susan, my friend here. We just don't like to write stuff down. We have completed level four, which is the highest level you could go, but we need to up to level three. Ms. Warren takes care of all of our credits, and she does all the accounting for us, but then from three to four, we have to do it ourselves and write it down and submit it to her. We have done everything that we need to do for four, but I really encourage you to consider becoming members of the Elected Official Academy. The cost is very reasonable. There are webinars, and then there's also on-site classes at the Michigan Legislative Council in March, and also the convention in September. Now, if you'll allow me, I want to switch hats for a minute. As I mentioned, I'm also president of the Michigan Black Caucus of Local Elected Officials, and our unit, we are a member of the National League of Cities, or the MBC LEO, and we would like to invite you to become members. We are totally, totally, totally non-discriminatory. Even though our name says Michigan Black Caucus, we are non-discriminatory. We accept anyone that wants to become a member. You do not have to be an elected official. We have an associate membership. We have elected officials membership. And then we have sponsors membership. Our membership for a whole year is only $35. So we can't really say, ooh, I can't afford the, can't afford the dues. No, the dues are affordable. And so I invite you all to please become members. There is a membership application in your packet, so please read it over. I had the pleasure of meeting with Councilmember Mitchell when we did our weekender. She was at the core weekender, or the advanced weekender, this past February. And also, Mayor, were you there? No.
It was Steve
Chisholm.
I'm sorry. You're there. Okay. Right. You were there. I'm sorry. But anyway, listen, I'm used to closed session. So after the closed session, y'all needed a chuckle. You needed a laugh. So, see, I'm just good for that. But anyway, thank you so much for allowing me to come and present this. Thank you for allowing me to talk about MBC LEO and the EOA. And we would like you to become members of both of them. Thank you.
Thank you.
Before we move on, I want to thank my colleagues, one for the mayor and Sandra, who helped me in this endeavor. You don't know what you did, but you did help. But it's always a collaborative effort when we're moving forward. And we are showing our leadership, and we're bringing everyone that's on the team as well, so this whole city can show that we are leaders and we're going to move forward. Thank you. Okay. Before I do that, I want to recognize Glenn Anderson, our state rep. Wayne County Commissioner.
Everybody gets promoted. Thank you. As the old saying, you can call me anything, but not as long as it's not late for dinner. You can tell I have too many of those. Thank you very much for the opportunity to come up and just give a very brief update. Congratulations, first of all, to our Mayor Pro Tem, Tim Williams, for his achievement obtaining this level. And I was sitting there with folks from MML, and it came back to me that back when I was on the Westland City Council many years ago, that I was the first, I believe, of our entire council to achieve level one, and later on went on to become a member of the first Elected Officials Academy Board, and because I really believe in its purpose and the value to all of us as elected people in the communities, help with budget information, training us on how to deal with budgets and deal with issues with the Open Meetings Act laws. And I actually went to one conference once that we were, that was way back, of course, we were looking at our first cable franchise. Mm-hmm. And that was a new thing. That was the thing that everybody was concerned about. And I actually went to one session, and John Pestel from Grand Rapids, with a firm out in Grand Rapids, was quickly becoming known as the go-to attorney to negotiate your cable franchise agreement. And I brought it back to my community, and the city attorney met with him, and they hired him to help us write our own first franchise agreement. So it's very valuable. I think it helps us sometimes stay out of trouble sometimes when we are, citizens a lot of times don't understand some of the things we're compelled to do as elected people. The law, and if your zoning is proper and the proposal that's in front of you, these are programs and educational programs that really help us, I think, understand how everything works, and it was very beneficial to me, and I commend you, Tim, for taking the time to do that.
Thank you.
It's a great statement about doing our job. A couple of things rolled through rather quickly. The commission recently approved the sale of excess property at 640 Temple, which was a Albert Kahn building downtown that had been very minimally utilized by the county, and we've been trying to get rid of a lot of different properties that aren't being utilized and that can basically get on the tax rolls eventually. And we've also agreed on a sale of Henry Ruff property. I don't know if you remember it was like a shop that was over there just south of Michigan Avenue behind the Library for the Blind, and also the sale of the Library for the Blind. So that'll be getting on the county tax rolls. They both actually sit in Westland, but those two properties, and now they're still trying to market the old Eloise property, which is because of all the infrastructure that's there, tunnels and everything, utilities, it's going to be a very tough thing, I think, to sell, and probably wind up the county. You'll have to almost just give it to someone for the cost of getting it prepped to be able to develop it. But those three properties have a value of, well, once the sale and everything is complete, they'll bring in about $12 million to the county. And so I applaud the county exec. He and I sometimes disagree on some things, but I believe in let's get rid of the properties we're not using and try to get them back on the tax rolls to help the local community as well as the county. I wanted to thank the mayor, too, and Mrs. Fields over here, Jeannie, for their support and helped me set up a tax forfeiture town hall at the Dozier Center. I think it was about 3 weeks ago now. And I think we provided a lot of good information to residents. And Eric Sabri, our county treasurer, was there. He really has gone out of his way, I think, to, with a lot of communities. I did one in Garden City after that one. And to hopefully help people stay in their homes if they've gotten sort of upside down with their taxes. He actually sat down with some people in Garden City. We had a much smaller crowd, but it was really a great attendance at the Dozier Center, and I was really happy to do that. I plan to try to do that next year or two again. And he's one of the greatest treasurers I've ever dealt with. He bends over backwards to help people. He wants, and all of our, I think, as elected people, I think our goal is always try to help people stay in their home. We want a house occupied and people paying taxes. We don't want them sitting vacant and running down. And every community has that issue, so we're doing our best, I think, to not add to that problem. But I think that was it. I lost my place on my phone, sorry. But, last thing. I laid a flyer on each of you, in front of each of your seats about an event that's coming up on June 17th. I'm trying this year to try to give kids something to do and for all three communities that I represent. What it'll be is a free skating day. They'll be able to get free skate rental. If they don't have roller skates, they can get free skate rental, and it'll be a three-hour session. We're going to try to have some fun things for them to do, and I think the owner of the establishment is going to donate a birthday party, a drawing for a birthday party we all paid for one of the people that attend that win the drawing. And so we're doing it. We're going to try to, we're right now planning on about 400 to 500 kids. And I don't know what kind of a challenge that's going to be with 400 to 500 kids that are all under 13 years old, but we're encouraging, in fact, anyone's required to call my office or email us and let us know that they're coming and how many kids, the names and that, and then we'll check them in. But anyway, if you could help pass the word, and Jeannie, if you would please maybe put that one up if everybody's okay with that on the website or something, the city. If you could do it, I'd appreciate it. We're trying to get the word out. It's, it'll be a challenge, but we want the kids to have something good to start their summer off. But anyway, thank you very much, and I apologize for taking too much time.
Right. Next thing, public hearing. Can I entertain a motion to open the public hearing?
We open the public hearing regarding the City of Inkster Code of Ordinance, amending the word city manager to mayor. Code of Ordinances per the new report.
All agree? Say aye.
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 Discussion. Oh, okay. Discussion. Discussion. No discussion. Okay. Okay. So no discussion on changing the code from city manager to mayor. So can we go to the vote? This is a public hearing.
Yeah, do they have anything?
Any comments question from the public?
Well, hold on, you did discussion. You kind of did the vote.
Yeah,
first. You did discussion.
No, tonight, we didn't vote yet.
You need to call. You need to vote whether we're going to open it up.
What?
Then we call people.
Aye.
who made the motion?
I'm Mayor Nolan.
Who seconded the motion?
Councilman Odom.
Let's open it.
Oh, you got to take the vote.
Take a vote.
Okay.
All those in favor say aye.
All those in favor say aye.
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 Also, to Matt. Amen. Okay. The ayes have it. Don't say nay. Okay. Now we're opening it up to the public. Does the puppy have anything to say about the special ordinance? You want to read it to you again?
Yeah, you want to explain it to us?
Sure. On all our code and ordinances, it now presently says city manager. Now that we do not have a city manager, that language will be changed to the mayor.
That's why we didn't discuss and have any questions.
I had to ask.
We don't want to change it to big daddy double P.
So there's no discussion?
Move we close the public hearing.
Support.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any nays? Ayes have it. Motion pass. Consent agenda. Get a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So move.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. Okay. Boards and commissions. Anyone have any
nominations? Xed out A.
Excuse me, we asked out A.
Yeah.
Boards and commissions. Are there any new appointments for boards and commissions? No.
Okay.
Anybody down to sin? Okay. Okay, no new appointments.
Second reading, I'll read it.
Item 8, an ordinance. The clerk's going to read the first one that we took out.
A first reading, so I'm going to read a first item number 2, a first reading on a proposed amendment to the City of Inkster Code of Ordinance for amending the word city manager to mayor in all the ordinances per the passage of the new city charter.
So that's just the first
reading.
And then how do the second?
Motion to open the second reading?
It's just the second reading.
Yep.
I'll read it. A second reading on a proposed amendment to the zoning map to rezone the north of Cherry Street between Inkster Road and Middlebelt Road from RM-1 multiple family residential district to M1 light industrial per the Planning Commission's recommendation.
New business.
Consideration and approval of a proposed amendment to the zoning map to rezone the north of Cherry Street between Inkster Road and Middlebelt Road from RM-1 multiple family residential district to M1 light industrial per the Planning Commission's recommendation.
Motion for discussion?
So move.
Support.
All in favor say aye.
Call for discussion. Discussion on the.
Okay, call for discussion on the motion. Does anyone have anything to discuss on the rezoning? Okay.
Call for the question.
You got to call for the question.
Call for the question. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no.
Nay.
Motion passed. Well, I'm sorry, nay.
Two nays.
Okay, motion passed. Item B.
Consideration and approval of an offer to purchase 4 residential properties as duly noted.
Motion for open discussion.
To approve.
Support.
Open discussion?
Discussion. I noticed that these properties are being sold for $2,010 per property.
That is correct.
And how was that amount arrived at? Is that...
Councilwoman, that was the offer that was submitted
I don't know the process in which they came up with that number. I did a second look at it as well, but that was the offer. We vetted it properly. As a matter of fact, we even had the owner or the purchaser come in and had a discussion with him, wanted to understand his level of commitment to obviously getting it done in a timely, expeditious manner. We were satisfied. We went through the clearance process for all four properties, we were satisfied with the offer, and as such, we put it forward to this honorable body.
And based on what I've read, this is for investment for more rental properties?
That is correct.
What are the conditions of the homes?
Obviously, we looked at the pictures, and we went and visited three of the four. Obviously, we did not get into the interior, so I can't speak to that. But the exterior, I would say, is definitely work to be done on those homes. And again, I feel very comfortable with the applicant and his level of commitment to getting it done. We asked his expertise and experience on, and we do know that he has done several in the area, more than several in the area, and we're comfortable with
and we
what's
have
before
our, us. Our standard reversion clause in there if it doesn't.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I got a question, Mr. Ford. We've been dealing with trying to clean up the city with various properties and trying to get people involved in maintaining and dealing with the upkeep of their property. I know you have no control over it. He probably doesn't neither. But I'm hoping that somewhere down the line, sort of convey that to him that, we'd like to have a properties maintained, and I know again he doesn't have control over it.
Yeah.
But I think.
But he does. Yeah. So and Councilman, I agree with you, and I think that's one of the reasons that we are, not doing a blanket or a blind transaction. I mean, we want to hear from the proposer or the slash developer. We want to hear from him. We want to. Take the temperature on his level of commitment, and obviously that is expressed in no uncertain terms that, we expect that commitment to be satisfied throughout the process. And I think it starts, it's for everybody, from henceforward. We need to have and take a more vested interest in communicating what our standards are with the folks that are coming in and purchasing these properties. So I agree with you wholeheartedly.
Thank you.
Yes.
One of the problems that I have is certain properties that's on this list really bad. Next door is bad. So how much money is a person going to actually come in here and invest? And will they get that back? Wait a minute, I wasn't finished. I'm sorry, I wasn't finished. I just think, when do we as a city decide when something is condemned? Because, like, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I can't see a person buying a house. The house next door needs to come down, and I've been fighting for that to come down for the longest. Mm-hmm. Property across the street, one house have already been demolished. It's really bad in that area, because one of these houses is in my area. It's really bad. And I'm just wondering, why would someone, I understand they maybe want to come in here for rental property, but at what cost? At what cost? Because this house that I'm looking at, everything needs to be done. So it's like for tear down, total tear down. It's going to cost thousands to rebuild that if they're going to do it the correct way.
So, to that, Councilwoman, well, obviously we have a code and ordinances and obviously regulations that create the standard for which he must do it and do it the right way. That's called a building department and a permit and making
and
sure. Absolutely. I can't speak to, I learned a long time ago, everybody has value or sees value in things differently, where we may say this is a tear down and condemn it, he may see an opportunity there and, has the means and the resources to put it in. This is his commitment and this is his investment in that area. I don't think, I can't really get into his mind, but I don't think he would make that type of investment without having actualized what the potential return would be. So I'm going to take this gentleman at his commitment, his word, and we will work with him to make sure that, obviously, that is satisfied. So.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I just want to say that we're in the process of writing ordinances that will take care of property of this nature. We're doing making the landlord responsible for upgrading the property, and if this property is not upgraded, we're doing time frames as well as the fact that if you don't develop this property, then it's a nuisance. It becomes a hazard. It becomes dangerous. These are the ordinances we're trying to put in place right now that'll make concerns of this nature less of a problem. Hopefully.
That's it.
May I ask Councilwoman Watley, does that ordinance also include monitoring of the property by the landlord? Because many times in our city, they rent and they walk away.
And they don't come back
to look at anything or to make sure that the property is being well maintained.
And these ordinances also require that an in-state agent who is responsible for that property is here. So not only are we in contact with the owner, we're in contact with his representative, and he can be compelled to maintain that property. And if not, like I said, we're not leaving this open. This is something we can do about it as a city after we've determined that this person is not proceeding in good faith.
Any other questions? I have one. This gentleman that's buying the property, does he have any other property in the city of Inkster?
I know Dearborn Heights, I believe several properties in the city of Inkster and around. I know he's done some work in Detroit. Phone call was made,
Have we seen any of the properties that he has?
I have not, no. But we have the developer, if you will, is here in the audience. If we are so inclined to ask that question to him, he's here.
Before we go there, because, it's pointless to ask the question to him. Ms. Fields, you did check on the other properties that he has in the city, right?
For code violations and owing the city money by way of taxes or water.
Okay.
But not quality of, other than code violations themselves.
Did anybody actually go out and look at them?
To see the quality of them? Yes. No, just for violations, code violations.
Okay. So he does own properties and he had no history of violation.
Here and in the surrounding communities.
Right.
So.
But the only way you get a history if there's a complaint made?
Or a code enforcement officer sees a violation, they'll write you a ticket. You don't have to, that doesn't have to start with a complaint. Code enforcement officer can actually see the violation and write you a ticket. Many of them start with complaints from the neighbors.
That's my concern, that I don't know how Well.
I mean, I guess we're, in a sense, and that's the reason why my first question, our reversion clause, if he doesn't do what he's supposed to do, we get the house back. It's a $2,000 house. I mean, we're not taking any risk here. He's taking a risk by purchasing them, and he's required to renovate them within a certain time frame. So we're not risking anything. You'll have the house back if he doesn't renovate the house. Then we can do whatever we want, need to do with the house at that point. But, you know, we want these houses renovated and back on the tax roll. That's what we want.
Well, I didn't mean to cut you off, Mayor, but I think that's the focus of most of us here. Mm-hmm. That we don't want it to get to that point where we even got to deal with it from a code enforcement.
You. Oh, these houses are already there. Have you seen these
houses? I'm talking about.
I mean, these houses are horrible.
I know that, but I'm talking about.
We have pictures.
I'm talking about in terms of the persons that's getting ready to buy them. We don't want to get it to the point where we got to have code enforcement involved. We want them to be able to deal with the houses and bring them up to the code to where they should be so it has an impact on the community and the city.
But that's what the reversion clause is for. If they do not do that, how many months? We get 6 months? 6 months, it reverts back to us. We keep their money, it reverts back to us.
But I'm hoping that we don't get them back.
But that's the whole point. You want to deal with reputable folks when they mine.
Exactly.
That's the point.
And the person that's fixing them up.
Yeah?
Well, I think it says a lot because we have the developer here to, you know, to justify his work. So, like,
I mean, I think
he has property in the city. On question, he's been here for quite some time. And like I said, we haven't had any complaints so far.
I'm not against what we're trying to do. All I'm saying is let's deal with it. He's going to do what he has to do. Let him do what he has to do. But my main focus is let us deal with moving this city forward in terms of dealing with the houses that we're talking about and having them looking good so we can move forward. That's all I'm saying.
We all agree on that, I think.
Any other questions? Okay.
Are we not going to talk to
him? You got a question for
him? What his other property looks like?
Yeah. I would really like to have someone tell me what they have seen of his other properties.
Could you come up
for
me? Could we have the developer come up? Oh, he's in over there.
Hi,
good evening. How are you doing?
Very good, very good. Thanks for taking the time to discuss this. I do own other properties. Actually, we just finished three projects here in Inkster. Most of our work before the beginning of last year, mostly in Dearborn Heights, Dearborn, and Detroit. We just finished 27105 Carlisle in Inkster, and now this property is rented. Also, for 29607 Steinhauer in Inkster, also rented right now. And as well as 29550 Annapolis, also rented right now. And 3616 Burns, also rented right now.
Okay.
So all these properties are up to code with the city. They've been completely renovated. Brand new kitchen, brand new bathroom, roof repairs, new plumbing. Once we go into the property, we change everything. We do from plumbing to electricity, roofing, everything. We spend a lot of money. That's why we cannot turn around and sell it right away. Because if we try to sell it right away, we're not going to recover our cost on it. So we try to rent it for a couple of years in the hope that this tenant will eventually turn it into a leased-on buyer, and then we'll put them into a program to help them fix their credit, eventually buy the property once they're able to do that. That's our goal.
Okay. Any further questions? Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. All in favor, say aye. Call for the vote. All in favor, we're calling for the vote on this item. All in favor, say aye. You got to
move on. The motion's already been made.
Motion's
made. We're going for the vote now.
Call it again.
All in favor to pass the motion?
What do y'all use?
You are confused?
I think they're confused.
The motion, my motion is on the table to approve the sale of the four houses.
Okay.
So we're just voting at this point. We already had discussion, so we're just voting.
Is that just confused about that? All the conversations? Okay. Okay, now, ready to vote on the sale of the property?
Yeah.
All in favor to vote, to say aye?
Aye.
All opposed?
Abstain.
All opposed, say nay?
Why are you abstaining?
I'm abstaining because I don't feel that it has been vetted enough.
You can't abstain for that reason. You can't abstain for that reason. You have to have like a vested.
Well, if you abstain, it's a no vote.
It's no vote.
Move forward.
Ayes have it. Motion passed. Item C.
To vote in accordance with the vote taken in closed session for Dukes.
Support. Quinn Coleman.
All in favor? Say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Item D is to vote in accordance with the vote that was taken in closed session. Smith.
So move.
Support.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Nay.
Okay. Motion passed. Ayes have it. Public participation. This is where we let the public ask questions, and you only have 3 minutes to ask your questions. We want to start with a candlelight.
Good evening.
Good evening.
All right, tomorrow we have a Downtown Development Authority meeting tomorrow here at 6 o'clock in this chamber. Special guest is Terrence Campbell. He's the Director of Cybersecurity at Wayne County Community College. He will be presenting along with Regina Ann Campbell, who is the Managing Director for Place-Based Entrepreneurship at Tech Town Detroit. Ms. Deshondra Johnson will also be here from the Michigan Economic Development Corporation, and Maxwell Cameron from the Wayne Main Street, right here in Wayne, Michigan. In addition, we'll be reviewing the proposed Inkster Farmers Market and Cultural Arts District. Mr. Paul Carr will be present, along with Ms. Akanam Obong, who's sitting behind me. The Eastern Market Corporation and Food Fair Network will also be in attendance for the DDA meeting. Last Thursday, we had our Inkster TIFA meeting. Pretty productive. We had Cliff Akuboji and from the Talent Improvement Agency from the state of Michigan come and speak to us about partnering, about workforce development, potential workforce development here in the city of Inkster, and creating better talent pool right here for citizens here. We also discussed the importance of putting together an immigration task force to develop a welcoming Inkster concept right here in the city. And last but not least, I was rereading the city charter. Doesn't hurt anyone to read the city charter so they can become more familiar with our rules and regulation and laws. One of the things, and I know I talked to you, Mayor Pro Tem, about this before, was in section 14.1, there is something about public utility powers. And basically what it's stating is that cities and municipalities like Inkster can create its own public utility company for revenue. And we're always looking for revenue here in the city of Inkster. What's the movement with public utilities right now on a local level is renewable energy. And so we have three cities in the United States, Burlington, Vermont, Aspen, Colorado, and Greensburg, Kansas. They're the first three cities in the nation that are totally 100% renewable. Burlington, Vermont has an entire utility company by itself that's all 100% renewable, whether that's on solar, water, or wind. Clean tech jobs from those type of utilities can generate a lot of money. Sacramento, California, in that area, they've generated over $1.5 billion in the past 3.5 years. And 44,000 new jobs in Orange County, California through clean tech and tied in with municipal utilities that have created a new tax base for that region. So it's just something to think about. We can talk more about it. Thank you for this time. Thank you.
You're welcome. Next, Gabe Henderson.
Good evening.
family. How's everybody doing today?
All right.
Hey, looking good there, bro. It's good to share, you know. I love it. That shows you know you care about it. Okay, what
it's
I want
teamwork.
I want to speak on our kickoff, our beautification, Inkster beautification cleanup. It's coming April the 29th. Okay, we're going to got kickoff on Booker Dozier Rec Complex at 9 o'clock. You know, on our calendar, it does, you know, give a state to that. And also, it tells the different locations where we're going to have the dumpsters. And I can read them off also. We're going to have dumpsters at Westwood Park, at Stoneman, east of John Daly. And we have Wheatley Park, we have a dumpster there. And Lamone Park, dumpster there also. And Booker Dozier Rec Complex. And we want all the citizens of Inkster who care, and I think there's a whole lot of us out there that come out on our kickoff. Anyway, and we're going to have some light refreshments, and we're still going to be in need of certain, you know, donations to help us along. And Ms. Tony Bailey, they can get in touch with her. She can probably fill in on some of the things that, you know, we got people going to be giving us some water and a few other things. We're going to have a coffee. We're going to have donuts. We're going to have some snacks. And then we have some donations from some companies, you know, gloves and trash bags and all that. So I just want to say I hope everybody will show up. I think it's going to be a nice day, April the 29th. Mm-hmm. We're going to do our best to get Inkster do look a little bit better. We've been having a whole lot of good, active, you know, people and looking out to try to watch out for these guys that doing all this dumping. You know, we got some, I call them good old boys, you know, from other communities. They do all their little work and, you know, fixing up, making good money in the city of Inkster, and they don't want to pay, you know, haul their stuff away when and it's sad, but that's, you know, some people, they like to put salt in the wounds of a community. We're supposed to be healing those wounds. We're a little wounded, and you got some people from other areas, you know, that want to keep put salt on wounds. So, but we're watching out for these guys and make sure that, you know, people reporting them. So I just want to say, it was some discussions. Okay, 30 seconds, yeah. It was some discussion about Parkwood Park, about some guys, good old boys over there, other communities on there, they're out there, they call urban miners and all that. You know, they're going with their program in the ground, and so I don't know what they're looking for. But I know one time they had stripped that area out, they took all the playground equipment out when they tore down the schools and all that. Our block club, we've been trying to get that redeveloped. And we fill in a lot of those holes that, you know, when they took out the playground equipment and all that, get right it fixed up. Lately, we haven't did anything over that area, but we would like to, in the near future, to try to develop an area for the kids. We still got quite a few kids in the community. Keep them out of the street if we can get that area developed. Keep them out of the street, you know, put some basketball goes up there and all that. So I just want to say something on that. Okay.
Okay.
And, you know, I want to say this. I always try to do my best and let God do the rest.
Okay,
so
thank you.
That should be.
Thank you, Gabe.
All right, I love y'all.
Thank you.
We love you too.
Next, Mr. Jeffrey Carter.
Hi, Jeffrey Carter. I live right down here down the street. I want to talk about the 2014 robbery of my house. I was robbed at gunpoint. Two men put guns to my head on my porch, forced me into the house. 2 days after the robbery, I went to the police station and handed in a list of the missing items. 10 days after the robbery, I went into the police station and talked to the detective and told him that who the name of the person was, and he corrected me and told me the name of all three individuals that entered my house in 2014. I had to go into the city hall, and I think it was November of 2016, because I repeatedly seen one of the individuals hanging out in front of the police station and in front of Michigan Motel. But nobody could make an arrest. Nobody would press charges. Your detective wouldn't do his job. Now I understand that the girl finally got convicted by your new detective. He pressed the charges. She went to court. She got convicted. There was two other men involved in this robbery. One, I understand, and I've been told, was killed. But the third one is still out there at large and known by the detective, but nobody will press charges. I would like to know, my question is, should I ever expect charges to be brought against the people who robbed my house? This has been a war against the police department.
Okay, we will answer you in writing. We're going to get with the police chief and the investigators to find what went on.
I've already tried to work with the police chief, prosecutors, FBI, state police, everybody. It's the detective that needs to do his job.
Okay, well,
it took the new detective 5 minutes to press charges against the individual.
Well, we're going to talk with the police chief to get to with our new detective and get information, and we'll get back to you.
Well, your old detective is still around, right?
No, I'm talking to the new detective.
Yeah, but you have one that's been here for quite a few years.
Yes.
Was here 2014. I mean, he treated me violently. He treated me badly. He acted like it was my fault that I got robbed. I shouldn't live here.
Did you file a complaint with the police department about his behavior?
I tried to get a hold of the new police chief on several occasions that never had my phone calls returned. Since this girl got convicted, I've tried to talk to your detective agency a couple of times, and no phone call has ever been returned. A funny thing is, this person was convicted of armed home invasion with a sentence of 10 to 15 years. They failed to notify me of her conviction or her sentence. She got 2 years for armed robbery. I don't know what's going on with the city, what's going on here, but, you know, it's obviously, you know, like you see in Detroit, like I was saying, two Detroit cops were shot on their porch, on a porch of an individual.
Mr. Carter.
Because he thought they were breaking in.
Mr. Carter.
That's why it's happening.
We'll give you the phone number and address so it can be handled.
To go through all that is, this has been turned over to the DA's office.
Okay.
Office.
Next, DeAndra Watley.
Good evening, Mayor Good evening. And Council.
Good evening.
I just wanted to come up and remind you guys about the potato fundraiser, of course. And then, why are you laughing?
He's you already have our money.
I have your money, but I don't have his money, Steven's money, Mr. Fort, no. I don't have everybody else's money yet.
Yeah,
no.
Right.
Potato fundraiser, you can eat. Oh gosh, you threw me off. 11 o'clock, April 29th, at St. Clement's Church, $5 tickets, and that's all I'm going to say. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, she wants me to tell you the address, 4300 Harrison, and that's in Inkster. Okay, thank you.
Okay, City Clerk.
No comments at this time.
No comments. City Treasurer.
We're having the second City Council study session on the Mayor's recommended budget this Wednesday at 3 o'clock here at City Hall. So we welcome anyone who's interested in discussing or asking questions about the recommended budget to come out on Wednesday.
Mayor and Council of Communication. And we're going to start. Would the mayor we start? Council President Watley?
Okay. I would just like to remind people that I am still accepting your applications and your sponsorships for the 48th Annual Memorial Day Parade being held May 29th. At 12 noon, the parade will start. We have a wonderful lineup for you. I think you're going to be kind of excited. So So we want everybody to get on board and make sure you're either involved in it financially or participatory, okay? The second thing, I would like to advise you that my advisory board meeting will be Thursday, April 27th at 6 p.m. at High Praise Cathedral, which is at 4010 Moore Street, 4010 Moore Street. That's the advisory board meeting for District 3. Of course, the entire community is welcome. The entire city is welcome. We'll be discussing a lot of things, the least of which will be volunteerism, because there's a lot we can do if we start working together. And last, I would like to let you know that the Human Resource Department, along with the Clerk's Office, we will be rolling out a citizen evaluation card on May 1st. Now, there will be a box sitting out in the hall there at when you come in, and there will be evaluation cards which you can sign and rate the service you received from the city. This is our way of getting your input where things are going on to make sure that your our service is up to your standards. So we'll be rolling that out May 1st. I'll be mentioning it more, showing the card. Well, I think I have the, one of the cards here. This is what the evaluation cards will look like, and they just ask you a few questions. And if you have something else that you wish to say, you can include it on the back and just drop it in the box there. These will be reviewed, and hopefully we will make improvements based on what you think should happen here in your city. So we're looking forward to rolling that out for the resident. And that would be it, Mayor Pro Tem.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Councilman Odin.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. I just want to say I'm proud of a person who was on the council with us for a while, Joel Jones. I'm a member of the local American Legion. And every month we get a newsletter or a newspaper in terms of activities that's going on related to the Army Reserves, and ROTC, etc. This month, we got a communication. It talks about our own beloved Joel Jones. They did a wonderful article on him in terms of being a mayor, being a on the council here, and now being a state representative, state level, and the job that he's doing. And I thought that was very worthwhile, that it should be mentioned to the people within the community. He's doing his job, he's doing what he has to do, he's moving forward, and he's leaving his name out front. So I just want to announce that. That's all I have.
Okay. Councilperson Mitchell.
Good evening, everyone. Two things. On this Wednesday, here in this chamber at 6 o'clock p.m., the Stand Up Fight Blight Forum. A number of illustrious people will be here to talk with you and to share ideas and information with you about how we as citizens can assist the city in cleaning up blight in the city of Inkster. So I hope that you will attend. There's some flyers in the window. Please take one and come out. The second thing is Ball Moulin Rouge is on May 6th. This is a celebration of Inkster's heritage. We are quite an outstanding city. I don't know how many people realize the rich history that this city has. And it is our purpose on that night to bring citizens together to talk about the city of Inkster, its rich history, and our bright future. So I hope that you will come out there, kicker cards, they call them these days, in the windowsill. Take one, and if you have any questions or you want to purchase a ticket, there are three places to get them, and you can make a phone call to reserve. We'd appreciate your attendance. Finally, I would like to say that thanks to Jerome Bivens, and thanks to our ordinance department, I'm telling you, it's a new day in the city of Inkster. They fixed the problem that had been in ongoing since last summer. And on one morning last week, I saw Inkster trucks going past my house. I thought that there had been a water main break, but when I came back in the other direction, I couldn't get through because they were cleaning up that issue. So I want all citizens to know that ordinance is on it. We're no longer accepting whatever you just want to give Inkster. We're a different place now. And we are going to make sure that we get our city cleaned up and keep it that way. And I'm very proud of those two departments because, as Mr. Bivens says, when they have to go and clean something up, that's the time they're taking away from the real duties of the Department of Public Works. So that's another reason why it's so important that we come out to learn about how we as citizens can help our city clean it up. Thank you.
Council President Howard?
I didn't at this time.
Not at this time, okay. Council President Chisholm?
Good evening, everyone. Just wanted to let everybody know I did attend the tax foreclosure forum that was held at the recreational complex. I had the pleasure sitting in on that and just acquiring a wealth of knowledge. And it's funny how after that, a couple of my residents within my district actually have reached out to me because of tax issues that they're having, and I'm able to give them the information and direct them in the right direction. So again, thank you, Mayor Nolan, Commissioner Anderson, and Eric Sabree, Wayne County Treasurer, for that. I attended also the Milan Main Street Basics. Main Street Basics training that was in Milan this last week. It was on Thursday. I'm gonna send the DDA an email about that from notes in the PowerPoint and everything that I received from that as well. Also went door to door passing out notices about my upcoming advisory meeting. I intend on hitting every single house that is in my district. Thank you to Councilwoman Watley, Andrew Watley, Andrene Holloway, Luana Abney. She's been a great asset as in my absence, like when I'm at work and stuff and passing out this information. We've gotten to Inkster Road, so if you haven't gotten a notice to your front door yet, just a real informal one, it's on the way. So you just got to be. Right, that's why I said it's on the way. You just got to bear with me. It's when it gets cold, it's kind of hard. So we've just gotten to Inkster Road from Beach Daily to Inkster Road. We haven't gotten across Inkster Road yet. So, and then also there are houses that are vacant, and someone asked me, why are you going up to that vacant house? And I said, why not? I said, because that's one of the things we don't do. We see a vacant house, we bypass it. We don't know what's going on in that property. We don't look in, we don't check on it. I saw padlocks and stuff on there, so I know someone comes back and forth to that house or has intent on doing something with it, but still, we need to know the statuses of what's going on with those houses. That is it, and that meeting is April 26, 2017, at New Birth Baptist Church at 6 p.m. And I did also receive some mail from a resident in my district, and it was talking about a rental-free crime program. I reviewed that. I'm going to be passing that information on to mayor and council because that may be something that we can enter as well, too. And it just kind of holds rental property renters to a higher standard when they come into our city, purchase property to rent out, and not follow up with their tenants who are doing God knows what, and we're sitting here complaining to our ordinance officers, police department, and come up here before mayor and council when it's really on the property owner to be handling that. And that's all I have.
Mayor Nolan.
Ooh, feels so funny sitting in this chair. All I want to tell you is shop Inkster, but. You know, I was encouraged last week. We had our budget meeting. We actually had, what, 7 or 8 residents there, which typically doesn't happen. I think half or more from Councilwoman Howard's district. I mean, they came out full force. I was proud that they were actually able to stay awake through that process. Since our realtors are here, you can hear some of the discussion regarding the sale of property. I think from going forward, I think when investors buy property or people who are homeowners, maybe you should, especially the ones who've already bought properties in Inkster, go check out those properties, take some pictures so you can come and tell us, look, they're doing a great job with their other properties. you know, we know you put eyes on it, laid eyes on it, and so we can both move forward with the confidence that they're going to do a good job. I think that would help us up here, because there's a lot of questions, and we have some serious council people about this blight issue. They're all sitting down, and they're not messing around, so we want to make sure, you know, the people we let do business in the city are doing a good job. But I think that'll help the property values in the whole city grow. I hope everybody had a happy Easter yesterday. I enjoyed myself. I just got back in town, time to make it to this meeting, so that's why Mayor Pro Temp is running. I think he did a good job, even though I think he's a little nervous. But he's doing pretty good. Inkster update. Everyone should have received the Inkster update last week. It was a newsletter mailed out to your home. We're trying to make efforts to keep information flowing in the community a little bit better. So we sent out over 12,000 of them. And we just want you to know what's going on. For those who don't come to council, you all know because you come to council meetings. For those who don't watch us on TV and come to council meetings, we want to get that information out so they'll know what we're doing as elected officials. I think that is it. Yeah. Oh, I already did the shop.
Through the chair.
So he borrowed my line.
Councilwoman.
Just one other thing. My garbage guru, Mr. Kara Woods, called me while I was at the meeting and stated that he drove through the entire District 3, and he was proud to say that he doesn't think we have not even a dumpster full of garbage in District 3. So I wanted to say that and let people know that he's on the case, as usual. Thank you,
Okay. Just the mayor stole my line. But I want to say thank you to Nate Ford and Jeannie Fields for their efforts. They get out and go look, they go hunt down prospects for new businesses to come into the city so our city can be more viable. They're looking for a new revenue on a daily basis. There are a lot of times when City Hall's closed on Friday, and I can see Nate and Jeannie here brainstorming on how they're going to get this prospect to come in and to open up shop here. And I'm going to commend them for a job well done. Because in the future, our tax revenue is going to go up, all the vacant property is going to be done, and we can truly shop Inkster a little better.
Got it in anyway.
So stay tuned. There are better things coming down the pike as far as shopping the city of Inkster. To my colleagues, I just want to bring to your attention. I need you to take a look at the attorney's contract that's going to be up this week. We need to sit down and talk about a renewal of the contract. So if we get together, we're going to do a special meeting or do it at the next month. Because after the 20th, it'll go on a month-to-month basis.
Should have discussed that orientation tonight. But let's do that next meeting. So after the 20th?
After the 20th.
So it would have been expired by the time
No, it doesn't expire. Well, yeah. It'll go on a month-to-month basis from that point.
We'll do it at the next
meeting. So until we stay on top of them, then it'll keep going on and on like that.
Okay.
One more thing. You don't do this, but he's
yeah,
sitting here.
Right. Whatever. No.
Go ahead.
I just wanted to let the residents know that you really should come out to the budget meeting. I have been going over budgets for years, but today I had a meeting with Treasurer Carrington, and he explained it so easily. I was like, my eyes didn't cross. I didn't go take a nap. I actually understood what he was talking about. So if you want to know how your tax dollars are being spent, you need to come out and listen to Mr. Carrington. He makes it so, you know,
clear,
easy to understand. So that's all I wanted to say. This is a mutual admiration society tonight.
They weren't there for a long time.
Most good term.
Can I get some support?
Yeah,
all the same time.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye.